He's like, this your dad chair, huh? And I'm like, yeah. He's like, well, I'm daddy now.
Hey, staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the shit that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, yeah, girls want girls.
Are you ready to order anything?
Yeah, I'm gonna do pound of crab legs, some Cajun fries, 3 potatoes, and then try to do a sausage. Hey y'all, welcome back to another video. So today I am gonna be doing a mukbang. I'm right here out to eat at the seafood place. I don't know, it's Sunday. I did my little Sunday routine and everything. And I'm like, I'm finna go get some crab legs, so I might as well do a mukbang. Yes, I'm trying to think right now what story time to tell you guys. I think I'm gonna tell you guys a story time about when I lost my virginity. And I will see y'all when my food comes out. I'm so excited, cause I already know it's gonna be good. If y'all not following me, go follow my Instagram right now.
Okay, so they bought out my Cajun fries first. These are so good. They bought out my Cajun fries first. And then I got my raspberry tea.
Aww.
They brought out my pound of crab. This is gonna be so good.
Okay, so to start off the story, I was at this time, I'm not gonna tell you how old I was, but at this time, like growing up, I was living with my mom and my dad, like in between. So this is the time when I was living with my dad, and basically, I have an older sister. She's like boy crazy. So like at the time, I don't know no better. Her best friend at the time was a guy best friend, and they had started like coming around my dad's house. I started feeling dude or whatever. I started feeling them. Mind you, they had been coming over for like 3-4 days back to back. On the fourth day, that night, my dad was upstairs the whole time. My sister had snuck outside. Mind you, we're young, so she shouldn't have been doing that. We shouldn't have been doing that, to be honest. She snuck outside to go see her boyfriend, but she had invited her best friend over, and my dad was upstairs. She had told me like basically like, oh, watch downstairs, like watch my best friend, so if dad comes down, like anything. Mind you, we're bold at this time. We're so bold. Like, my dad's upstairs with me, so I'm downstairs with him, he's downstairs with me, and I'm on one couch. So there's a long couch and there's a little small little recliner chair that my dad sits in. So he's sitting in the recliner chair and I'm sitting in the couch, the big couch. And so basically like we're right there, I'm on my phone. He's like flirting with me, but I'm young at this time, so I'm just blushing. And then he's like, come over here, like to the other couch. And I'm like, okay, like I go over there and he starts like kissing me and all that, bro. Kissing on my neck and everything. And then I'm like nervous at this point because, like I told y'all, I'm still the virgin. I'm nervous. So he's like kissing me and everything. And then after that, like, basically, he's like, this your dad chair, huh? And I'm like, yeah. He's like, well, I'm daddy now. First of all, now I'm really nervous. So he's popping his shit, like he's like trying to get me there. So I return to the big couch over here and I'm just like minding my business. I need some garlic butter. Can I get some garlic butter? Thank you. We'll continue the story. So I return back to the big couch. He comes over there. He starts kissing on me. Starts like taking my pants off and everything. And then like he goes to like stick it in. He goes to like stick it in. And I'm all like, it hurts, like hold on. Goes all the way in, I swear. I don't mean to stalk the nigga, but I like flinch at him, like, ooh, like, you know, like it hurts. Type. So then that happens and then like he starts going like in and out like 3-4 times. And then after that, had after that, I got nervous, so I just told him, like, leave, abort mission. Okay, so then, after that, like, I tell him to leave or whatever, boom, that night's over with. The next day is when I got caught, bro. So, basically, the next day, my dad and my stepmom go to party. They go out to party, and my sister's like, oh, I'm gonna invite my best friend over again today. So I'm like, okay, mind you, we have step siblings. Like, my dad's married to a woman at this point, and we have step siblings. So my step siblings are like downstairs watching a movie, right? And why are they fake sleep? So they're fake sleep, and we don't know that. So we bring the guys inside, bring them upstairs and everything. We're like in the room, like just chilling, like talking and everything. Mind you, the whole time my step siblings are calling my dad. They're calling him, they're telling him everything. So thank God we got them outside the house before my dad came back. But when my dad came back, I swear to God, I had a feeling that he knew. So I started deleting all the apps on my phone. And I'm telling my sister, like, do the same, like, delete all your apps because I got a feeling. It's like, you're paranoid, you're scary. So my dad's walking up the steps, boom, 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 boom. And my heart's beating as he's walking up the steps. He comes in the room, he's like, what niggas y'all had in my house? I get to looking, I said, no niggas, dad, you don't have nobody in your house. He was like, give me your phones, bro. In my brain, I'm like, I'm good, bro. My sister, you're dumb, like, you're so dumb. Like, how can you be so dumb? Thank you so much. If y'all know, bro, y'all need to get garlic butter every time. So basically, I'm like, you're so dumb. So boom, he takes my phone, he takes her phone. As soon as he takes her phone, bring, it rings. And who is it, bro? Her best friend. Bro, he texted my sister. He was like, Lexi is fired. My dad seen that, mind you, I'm young as fuck. My dad seen that, he said, Lexi fired. He said, what the fuck is he talking about, dad? And I'm like, dad, like, I promise you, we didn't have no one over here. Bro, like, I'm caught at this point, I'm caught. So then he has my sister call the boy. He has my sister call her best friend. And when she calls, she FaceTimes him. She's like, oh, best friend, where you at? And he's like, why, your dad's gone again? Boy, listen, I'll tell you, my dad started running after me. I ran downstairs, trying to lock myself in the bathroom. And then I ran down the stairs, grabbed me by my shirt, like, put me up on the wall, bro, I swear to God. Put me up on the wall, he's like, I'm finna out of you, like. And then my sister started taking off on my dad, like, she started fighting my dad, like, full fist, bone fist, like. She starts fighting him. And then once he gets the belt on her, whooping, tearing that ass up. Well, I tell you, she took that ass whooping for me. So then we go upstairs, we go to sleep. Mind you, I'm my dad's youngest daughter, so he's tripping, like, he's hot, bro. The next morning, we wake up, he calls me in his room. He was like, I was gonna whoop your ass in your sleep, but I didn't. He was like, I'm gonna take you to the doctors. He said, if I find out that you're not a virgin, I'm gonna whoop your ass. And I was just like, I just made up a quick lie, like, on the site. I was like, oh, like, something happened when I went to go sleep over at my friend's house, like, a long ass time ago. He was just like, Alexis, get out of my face. So I swear, after that, we were on punishment forever, like, we were on punishment for months.
When I tell you, I'm tearing it down over here, y'all don't even know. So good.
I'm gonna tell y'all this story though, about that I was just telling you in the middle. So mind you, I told you guys, we were on punishment for a month, like, for a long time. And in between that, we didn't have no phones. So me and my sister were sneaky, like, we needed phones, bro. We're not going without a phone. So we would get, like, little trap phones and everything. And this time that we got a trap phone, bro, my sister with this sneaky ass look, she not supposed to be with this boy. she keeps going with him. But this time she goes with him. She gives me the trap phone. And she's like, I'm going to text you from his phone. I'm going to go and I'm going to text you from his phone. And I'm like, okay. She goes. I'm all on the phone chilling. She's texting me like, Lexi, it's an emergency. She was like, you're my aunt. If anything, you're my aunt. So then I'm like, what's the emergency? So I go downstairs. Next thing I know, I see this bitch and the police. The police is looking me dead in my face. And I'm like, oh, like, I'm her little sister. I'm scared of the police. I don't give a fuck. So he's like, you got 10 seconds to call an adult or I'm going to bang on this door. When I tell y'all, my dad is a felon. First of all, the police at his house, and not only the police at his house, but you snuck your ass out. That's your ass. So I'm thinking fast, like, our uncle's over downstairs, and I just hurry up and wake him up, bro. When I tell you, that was gonna be our ass.
It has like a little bit, it's like face fries.
That was gonna be our whole ass, like, at that point, it would've been no getting out of that. Like, and then after that, we eventually got caught with the phone. Our step siblings were some fucking snitches, like, I swear to God. We went to a candy lady's house. If you're from the hood, you already know, like, if you live in an apartment, there's always an apartment that has a candy lady that sells candy in it. So, basically, we went to the candy lady house and come back, and my dad's like, where that phone at? He goes on the phone. He sees the Facebook that we're not supposed to have. And on the Facebook, my cousin was like, you know, on Facebook days, you used to be like flirting with guys, making little Tiviana's posts and all that and everything. So my cousin had made a post, like, something like, I could be the spaghetti to someone. No, the guy could be the spaghetti to my meatball. Some corny ass shit. My dad, bro, was hot. Like, it's always me. It's always me, the one in the middle. So in our family, our cousins are really close, like siblings. I swear to God, my dad called my aunt, bro, brought her to my dad's house, and we collectively, all of us got an ass whooping together. Like, when I tell you, we was getting our ass tore up together. Like, we was just doing hella shit we had no business doing. And at our age, we really had no business doing it. So that's the story time on that. I'm gonna continue to eat my food right here. And I'm gonna just give y'all a little update. So recently I just moved in my apartment and everything. And I'm gonna be doing an apartment tour soon. This is my second apartment. I moved in my other apartment like in July. It hasn't even been a year. I had to break my lease for some reason I don't want to talk about right now. Eventually I'll open up about the situation, but right now. But yeah, so I had to move, and now that I moved, I really love it there. Like, I've been creating content every single day. Like, I just love it. The whole aesthetic of where I live. I mean, I do still come back out here, and yeah. But all I'm gonna say, bro, growing up, I regret losing my virginity to, not to who I lost it to, but the age that I lost it at, where I lost it at, when I lost it. Yeah, I just feel like I should have took it more serious. But since I didn't have no one to look up to, like, I was just looking up to my sister. So I can't blame her, because you feel me, I'm grown. I didn't have to do what I did. At the time, I wasn't grown, but I was old enough to make my own decision type shit. So yeah, that's that story time. That's way more stories where that came from. I don't even know. This man keeps watching me eat these crab legs. Like, it's not hidden today. I don't know. It usually be hidden different, but today, I don't know if it's because they already put garlic butter on it or like what. I don't fucking know. I am starting my workout journey tomorrow, so I won't be eating crab legs. One thing about me, I'm gonna break the whole crab down. You hear me? I need to go home and film this haul for y'all too. Last night I went to sleep late. I was editing that Brooklyn Frost video. If y'all haven't, go watch that Brooklyn Frost video. I posted it. It's going up. That one's getting a lot of views. I think it's because Brooklyn did promo for it and she reposted it on her story. But yes, I'm gonna finish eating and I will see y'all in the next video. Thank y'all for coming to join my story time. Comment below if y'all want to hear more story time. I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye, y'all.